So two things I recommend to do in aquaponics in autumn, just before the winter season. So in aquaponics, same as in a classic garden, we are growing plants that are adapted to a specific season, which means that in summer we grow, for example, tomatoes, we're going to grow a variety of fruit crops that are going to be able to grow during summer, but obviously they're going to die in winter. And there is a transition between the summer crop and the winter crop. When those plants are starting to die, that's when we want to start to clean the grow bed, and that's when we're going to try to remove the root. You know, in a classic garden, sometimes you can just leave the plants and they're gonna die. If you work with permaculture, they're gonna die and they're gonna be a source of fertilizer for the classic, for the soil basically. They're gonna add some nutrients in the soil, some organic matters, which is great and totally makes sense to do this in a garden, in a normal soil, in permaculture. In aquaponics, this is a little bit different, depending on how you deal with your aquaponic system and the different water parameters. But if you have an aquaponic system that is mature, that has been running for years, you have already in your grow bed a lot of organic matters. Obviously you got some fish poo, but you also got a lot of roots from the plants. You got some bacteria, a big biomass of bacteria. And therefore you got all those organic matters and they constantly release nitrogen into the water, which means that the nitrate level in the aquaponic system is already quite high. So if you have a lot of fish and you want to keep your nitrate level at an acceptable, manageable concentration, you need to make sure you don't have too many organic matters in your grow bed. And that's where we make a difference between a classic soil and aquaponics. A classic soil, a classic garden, you want to add always a lot of organic matters because it's very rare. It can happen that you have too much nitrogen, too much nitrate available in the soil. But most of the time it's in deficiency or it's just well balanced. It's not very often that you got too much nitrate. In aquaponics, we got the fish, so we can't exceed a certain concentration of nitrate. Therefore, it's very interesting when it's winter and the plants are dying to try to remove the roots. So we're gonna try to pick the plants with the roots and not just cut the leaves and let the roots in the system, thinking, oh, it's some food for the ecosystem. As I said, it is food for the ecosystem, but we don't want to exceed a certain concentration of nitrate into the water for our fish. So here we're gonna try to remove the, for example, I got some tomatoes at the end of the season. When I remove them, I'm gonna try to be very gentle and to remove as much as possible of the roots of those plants. So that's the first thing you need to do when you have this transition between the summer crop and the winter crop. So basically in autumn. The second thing you need to do, once you remove all the summer plants, you're gonna remain with a few plants that are able to go through the whole year. But then you have also this period where you have to plant the seeds for the winter crop. So winter crop, I'm talking about cabbage, I'm talking about cauliflower, a lot of different things that are able to grow during winter. But before planting those plants, what is interesting to do is to basically move the media. So clean the grow bed, and I made a specific video about how to clean a grow bed, but just quickly I show you how we do it. But that's the exact good moment to do it. It's in winter or in autumn, in the transition between summer and winter. Let's have a look. So this is the two actions that I really recommend you to do between summer and winter. And in this case, if you do this every year, you're going to have a very healthy ecosystem and you're going to avoid to have a problem where you got a nitrate level that is constantly increasing. It's really going to help you to manage your aquaponic system in the best conditions, and also it's going to help to have a good water flow, because when you clean the grow bed, you release all the organic matters and you have a good aeration. So the system is really, really efficient. It limits the quantity of disease you can have in the system, but it also increases the whole efficiency of the system, because you got a good population of bacteria that are here ready to work for you. If you are new to this channel, I recommend you to get access to the 6 steps aquaponics training, which is available in the description of the video just below, or in the I like information in the corner of the video. In this training, you will get access to some very important information, such as some limits that are very specific to aquaponics. For example, the quantity of fish that you can have, comparing to the volume of the grow bed, or the design of the system, volume of the fish tank comparing to the grow bed, all those type of information that are very important if you want to build your own aquaponic system and manage it in good conditions. So it's free, and again, it's in the description of this video. You're going to find a link and it's going to give you access to this free training. You can also subscribe to the channel and receive one video every week. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, and I see you in the next one. Bye bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.